and this gospel of the kingdom.
Come on.
This gospel of the kingdom.
Hmm.
Can you tell me Jesus brought religion? He said the gospel of this kingdom.
Come on.
Will be preached
in
all the world.
Hey.
This gospel of the kingdom shall be preached in all the world.
Yes.
And we can see today.
Mm.
Now, can you tell me that Jesus brought religion? Swear. To the atheists out there, you have no idea who Jesus is. You ain't got a clue.
Hmm.
But you need to humble yourself and understand the word of God. Because the word of God does not lie.
Yeah, man.
The word of God does not lie. And it says, this gospel of the kingdom will be preached in all the world as witness to all the nations.
Mm.
As a witness, meaning you've got no excuse. The gospel will be preached in all nations.
Mm.
Nobody will have an excuse to say you did not know Jesus. Nobody will have an excuse. And the Bible says, when the gospel of the kingdom is preached in all the nations, then the end will come.
Yep.
The end will come.
Yep.
And we'll see who will be laughing. We'll see who knows God. Mm. We'll see who knows God for real.
Mm.
That's your so-called pride.
Come on.
That's your so-called pride. You'll be put down low. Jesus came to save the world. And whosoever believes in Jesus shall be saved.
Woo.
It is a guarantee that when you come to Jesus, he will restore you.
Mm.
He will transform your life.
Amen.
He'll make all the difference.
Yeah.
They that put their trust in Jesus. They that come to Jesus will have eternal life with Christ Jesus. Jesus said that where I am going, that you will be there also. Where I'm going, that you will be there also. Now let me tell you something, other than heaven, it's far better than this place. Heaven is far better than this place. The Bible says, what would it profit a man if he gains the whole world but loses his soul?
Wow.
You can have everything in this world, but your soul, when your soul is not in Jesus, everything else is meaningless.
Come on. Come on.
The Bible says, when you seek the kingdom of God and his righteousness, everything else added to you is bonus.
Mm.
That is why,
good,
when you seek God, when you come to God, everything else is bonus. So why would you chase after so many things, but you leave God aside? Why? Because man is wicked. Humanity is evil and greedy and selfish. But let me tell you something.
Worn out, bro.
Let me tell you something. God has not changed. Jesus has not changed. Jesus is still the same.
Today, yesterday, and forever. Mm. okay?
Now Jesus said this word. Jesus said, I am the door. Anyone enters by me, he will be saved. And will go in and out and find pasture. Jesus said, I am the door. He did not say religion is the door. He did not say philosophy is the door. He didn't say the government is the door. He didn't say education is the door. Jesus said, I am the door. And he that comes through the door will find pasture. He that comes to Jesus will find rest for your soul. Rest for your soul. Some of you, you work 9 to 5. You're still not resting. You're still pressed. He's not even paying the bills. Some of you, you got stressed and depressed. You're still not satisfied. Some of you, you have all the money in your bank account, but you're still not satisfied. Jesus said, I am the door. He that comes in will find pasture. Do you know what pasture is? A place of peace. A place of no fear. A place of sanctification. A place of restoration. When you come to Jesus, you are restored. When you come to Jesus, you have rest for your soul, peace for your life, no depression, no stress. How do I know this? Because I have an awesome relationship with Jesus Christ.
Come.
Woo! That is why. Some people look at me. Some people look at me and they think I'm crazy. Some people look at me and they start to sweat. Some people look at me, they look at me funny. Because why? They don't have what I have. Because when you have Jesus, when you have Jesus in your life, it is greater than alcohol. It's greater than drugs. Some people get high on drugs and alcohol. But let me tell you something. When you have Jesus living in your life, he satisfies. Woo! When Jesus lives in your heart, there is hope, somebody. There is joy. There is peace. Let me tell you something. They that believe in Jesus will not be disappointed. They that come to Jesus will be saved. The Bible says nor is there salvation in any other, for there is no other name under the heavens given among men by whom you must be saved. The Bible says, there's no other salvation under the heavens by whom you shall be saved. But Jesus. That is why religion cannot save you. What? Religion cannot save you. There is no other name by whom you shall be saved but the name of Jesus. God said, I have exalted the name of Jesus above every other name. That is why Jesus is not just a prophet. He's not just a good person. He's not just a teacher. He is God in the flesh. Okay? Can I show you? Because some people think we come here to just make noise. We don't know what we're speaking about. Without controversy, great is the mystery of godliness, because God was manifested in the flesh. God was manifested in the flesh, meaning God came down as a human being. And do you know who that person is? Jesus. It is right here. Right here. The Bible does not lie. The Bible does not lie. It says God was manifested in the flesh, justified in the spirit, seen by angels, preached among the Gentiles, believed on and in the world, received up in glory. When Jesus Christ came, the angels saw him. When Jesus Christ came, he preached among the world. When Jesus Christ came, people believed in him. When Jesus Christ came, oh my God, he went back to heaven. He went back to heaven. The Bible does not lie. Show me.
Someone wrote it.
Do you know why, madam? I've experienced it. You see, some people say the Bible lies. If the Bible lies, why have I experienced the Bible? And I can show you, and I can keep on showing you so many things in the Word of God that is relevant today. That is why Jesus does not lie. People lie, but Jesus does not lie. People in the world may lie, but Jesus does not lie. Some people, they keep on talking. They keep on talking. But they're not just speaking the truth. Because the hearts are evil. The hearts are evil. The hearts are far from God. That is why pride is in your life. Pride is in your life because you don't want to know God. Do you know where pride came from? Do you know where pride came from, not enough? Pride came from the devil. The Bible says that the angel Lucifer, the devil was in heaven with God. the devil wanted to be like God. How can the devil be like God? Because God is the one who prayed to the devil. And the devil and the one God of heaven, the angels in heaven, they rebelled against God. They disobeyed the order that was in the kingdom of God. And guess what? The devil and the one third of heaven were kicked out of heaven. Why? Because pride won't stay in heaven. No sin can stay in heaven. No sin. Pride is a sin. Pride is a sin. And even today, people are saying, oh, we don't need God. Da, 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 da. We don't need God. We just want to be who we are. Let me tell you something. God is holy. God does not make mistakes. God is a perfect God. He does not make mistakes. You may make a mistake, but God does not make a mistake. Even when humanity sinned against God, God still forgave humanity. God forgave humanity, and He sent Jesus to deal with sin once and for all. Even when we are far, away from God, when we did not even want to love God, He still came. Jesus still came and came to restore us and came to reconcile us and came to reconcile us back to God. Isn't that good? That we have a God who restores life. We have a God who's forgiven. We have a God who's merciful. We have a God who's compassionate. We have a God who's righteous. We have a God who is holy. Jesus is holy. Jesus is love. Jesus is peace. There is no sin. There is no darkness. There is no evil in Jesus. That is why when you come to Jesus, that is why when you come to Jesus, He changes your heart. That sinful heart, that dark heart. And He transforms your heart. And He gives you a new heart of love and joy and peace and holiness and righteousness. When you come to Jesus, something changes on His life. That is why I am serve a God of pride. I serve a God of peace, of love, of justice. That is my God. My God is Jesus Christ. Woo! My God is Jesus. And He is. The Alpha and the Omega, meaning Jesus Christ, is the beginning and the end. Let me tell you something. The Bible says everything will pass away, but my word will never pass away. The word of God will still be the word of God. The word of God will not change. The word of God is still the same. The word of God is Jesus. It's Jesus Christ. Not religion, but Jesus. The truth in Jesus. And that is what the world needs to understand. That religion cannot take you to heaven. But what would take you to heaven is knowing Jesus as your Lord and personal Savior. Knowing Jesus Christ. Having a relationship with Jesus Christ. Knowing Jesus Christ. Following Jesus Christ. Obeying the word of God. Turning away from sin. Turning away from sin, not enough. No sinner. No sinner will make it into the kingdom of God. You must be born again. You must be born again. If you're not born again, you cannot see the kingdom of God. When you're born again, it means that you have received the Spirit of God in your life. When you're born again, you have acknowledged that you're a sinner and you need the forgiveness of the Lord. You need the mercy of God. You need God to help you to live a life that's pleasing before Him. When you're born again, the nature of sin is taken away from your life and you receive the new life that is in Christ Jesus. You must be born again. If you're not born again, you cannot make it to heaven. If you're not born of the Spirit of God, if you're not a child of God,
go to different churches that I go to and to every yard he goes to as well.
Trent,
what's that? I want to check you out. I used to go to New Generation and I started with God video.
You know lantern is?
Yeah, I know where it is.
So you get the totem lane train, tram.
The Bible says
you get off of Grand Street
into the kingdom of God.
You'll see it anyway, it's a big fat tube road, isn't it?
Without Jesus Christ.
There's one service at 7:30 and the evening service is about 11:30, I think.
The morning
sucks.
I can't do that, the morning, it's too early.
Evening is 7:30, isn't it?
In the night?
Yeah, yeah.
And morning was at 7:00.
Yeah, morning 7:00, yeah.
Yeah, serious time in the morning.
So 7:30 at night.
I used to go to New Generation.
Jesus,
4 years I baptized there, but I changed.
The devil
I go to God's Vineyard sometime,
because the Bible
it's
says,
like I'm not settled back yet.
The devil
I need something.
Comes to kill.
Something changed my mind.
The devil nothing will happen.
She's here, Trent.
Huh?
She's here, Trent. I go in the evening.
Jesus!
Oh, yeah. Okay.
Hey, spell!
Hot. Say, stop. No,
I'm here and God.
Yeah, I've talked to
him. I just stand with him, innit?
Yeah. Yeah.
So when I get to see more one people,
yeah.
Just come and stand, like,
yeah, on yeah. That's good.
That's good. Just support him, like.
Yeah. Yeah.
He's alone sometimes, and people like probably think he's a crazy person.
That is
you know,
the
other people, they don't understand. So God told me to stand with him.
God told you to see that.
You get excited about Jesus?
No, the ones don't understand him. He's a crazy person on his own.
Do you know why? We get excited about Jesus. Because he saved us. He transforms your soul. He saves you from darkness. He saves you from sin. He gives you hope. He fills the heart with love.
Is that what you're doing then?
Yeah.
Same thing.
No, yeah, I mean, I preach sometimes as well. Mm? I preach sometimes as well.
You preach as well?
Yeah.
It's good when you've got people around you, like, support.
Yeah, that's right.
You can say all kinds of words. Do you see me crying? Jesus Christ is still the same. Let me tell you something.
You have some leaflet.
Check in my bag.
Oh, yeah, in the bag, yeah.
Jesus. He does not lie.
Jesus, have mercy upon the Holy Spirit.
Some people, they got no idea.
Yeah.
They got no idea about Jesus. Some people have no idea about Jesus Christ. Because if you really know Jesus Christ, you have an intimate relationship with God. Jesus said, if you see me, you have seen the Father. How many people today have heard the voice of God? How many people and not enough know Jesus for real?
For real.
Some people, you talk too much. You talk too much. You don't know God. And when somebody's speaking about God, you laugh all yourself. But let me tell you something, not enough. God does not lie. Do you want to believe that the devil's lies? Or do you want to believe God? Who do you want to believe? Do you want to believe the devil's lies? Or do you want to believe Jesus? Who do you want to believe? Because I can assure you this, my man. There is good and there's evil. There is good and there's evil.
Come on.
Which side do you want to be on? Because me and all the other Christians out in the world, we are on the winning side. We are on the good side.
Hey.
We are on the side that leads to heaven.
Come on.
Let me tell you something, not enough. There is
yeah.
the good side, and there is the bad side. Where do you want to go? Your life is too short. You think you got all the life in this world. Life is too short. You don't know tomorrow. You don't know tomorrow, madam. Life without Jesus. It's hopeless. Life without Jesus. That is why Jesus Christ came. That whosoever believes in him, whosoever believes in Jesus, shall be saved. Isn't that a good thing? That when you believe in Jesus, you shall be saved. So it's one thing. What bad thing did Jesus do? Tell me, not enough. Maybe I don't know what I'm speaking about. Maybe I'm not telling the truth. Maybe I don't understand God. What did Jesus do? Maybe I might be crazy. Maybe I don't know what I'm speaking about. Maybe I don't know God. Tell me. Tell me, Nana. Do you know God? Have you heard God speak? Let me tell you something. In order for you to speak about God, you must hear His voice. In order for you to speak about God, you must have a relationship with Jesus. Every Christian has a relationship with Jesus. Every Christian hears God speak. Unless you're all crazy. Unless we don't know what you're speaking about. Unless you're telling lies. But there's evidence that God has changed our lives. That is awesome. It is evident that God has changed our lives. That is why we don't just speak. We speak because we have a relationship with Jesus Christ. And experience is the best teacher. That is why when people insult us, we laugh. Why? Because it's funny. Do you know why? When people insult us because of the word of God, we laugh. Do you know why? Because we feel sorry for them. Because they don't know God. Let me tell you something, Nadia. You have everything to lose without God. Let me tell you something. Money cannot take you to heaven. Your intellect cannot take you to heaven.
Amen.
Science cannot take you to heaven. Your education cannot take you to heaven. Money cannot take you to heaven. My God, my God. Religion cannot take you to heaven. Science cannot take you to heaven. Evolution cannot take you to heaven. Can I make that clear? What can take you to heaven? It's Jesus. It's only be Jesus. What can take you to heaven is knowing Jesus as the Lord and personal Savior. What can take you to heaven is having an intimate relationship with Jesus Christ. What can take you to heaven is knowing Jesus. Not just by going to church, but to have an intimate relationship with Jesus Christ. What can take you to heaven is knowing Jesus. That is why you need to come to Jesus. That is why you need to ask Jesus to fill your heart. That is why you need to ask Jesus.